Hi, and welcome to this demonstration of how to configure rules in Aimetis Symphony 7. Start by logging into the web-based administrator client. Once logged in, you will be brought to the devices section. Before configuring a rule, you want to ensure that the camera you wish to create a rule for has analytics running. You can see that the camera we are selecting has analytics running based on the All Analytics listed on the far right column. To ensure, click on a camera to bring up its details. Scroll down to Add-ons, and we can see the indoor people tracking analytic has been turned on. Click Configure to review the analytics configuration, mask, and calibration. You can adjust the perspective of the analytic by dragging around the camera icon to make the size of people more realistic around the scene. Once you have your initial settings configured to your liking, click OK. Now we are ready to create our rule. Start by clicking on the Rules tab at the very top and ensure you save any changes you've made to the camera. We are now in the Rules section and we wish to add a new rule, so click Add. There are three main sections when configuring a rule: Events, Actions, and Schedule. First, we want to create an event, so click on New Event. We then need to pick a device from the cameras or I/O and camera motion detection trees. We want to select a camera here. Select the camera in question you wish to create a rule for and click OK. Inside the Video Engine drop-down menu, you can see the analytic we want to configure a rule for. In this case, it is indoor people tracking. We want to throw an alarm if someone has been loitering for at least 30 seconds, which can easily be done under the Behavior section. We can also isolate a specific area for the tracking. We can use the masking tool to draw and narrow the area we wish to apply the loitering rule to. In this case, we want to watch the area directly in front of the watch's display. Now that we've defined the properties of the rule, we now want to name it. This rule will be used for customer service purposes, so we can name it Waiting for Clerk. Then click Save. The next section we need to define for the rule is the actions. We want to create a new action set. We have already set up the alarm for the camera, and we could choose a different camera if we wanted to from the drop-down menu on the right. We can also select from which cameras we want to automatically start recording once the alarm has been triggered. And if we want, we can add an email notification to the rule as well. In the email section, we can designate which email addresses to send a notification to if an alarm is triggered. Just as with the event section before, we need to name the action. In this example, we are labeling it Email Alert Customer. Now that we have a name, we can click Save. The next step is setting up a schedule for the rule to operate under. We can choose from existing schedules or create a new one. We've already created a business hour schedule that we can select here, but if we want to double check the schedule, we can click Edit after selecting this set schedule. After reviewing the schedule, exit out or save. The final step to configure this rule is to apply a rule name, and in this case, that's Alert on Waiting Customer. Click Save, and you've now created an entire rule. Thank you for watching this demonstration of how to set up and configure a rule in Aimetis Symphony 7.